Hi, welcome to Laura's View and Tarot 2. Tonight I wanted to talk a little bit about voting, specifically the topic of quantum voting and a little bit about voting in general. I am a voter. It's probably no surprise to you. I tend to look like milk and cookies and somebody's grandma, and I am somebody's grandma, but I'm more than that. And I know that America isn't the only country that has had a lot of issues with election fairness and election integrity. I believe France just had some of that this past weekend. I've heard my neighbors over in Canada saying the same thing, that election integrity is an issue. We are told that quantum voting is the answer to that. It's an intuitive system that will register one person, one vote, and in no way can that vote ever be switched or reassigned or misused. It sounds wonderful. I know a couple of years ago, we were told that actually quietly, quantum voting was already in place. I kept waiting, and that it had been used in our last recent major election. Remember, I have to be careful how I phrase things here. I kept waiting for that information to become public and for a correction to be made. And then we were told that it was on the shoulders of the citizens to take care of any election integrity issues from the local level on up. Well, that involves courts, and our courts aren't fair and honest. So I kept hoping that the military would step in and do a correction. And I thought it was right that they should. I mean, the future of our country was at stake. And then I heard that the military was afraid of optics, that if they stepped in, history books might say it was a coup, so they didn't. And I wanted to say to the military, and I guess I'm saying it now, I wish you'd had the balls to go on faith that what would go down in the history books was that a correction was made, that justice was done, that you upheld the rights of citizens to have their votes go where they intended them to, and the results to be based on those votes. Well, and I know there's probably military people watching this that are going to say, well, I had the balls. Don't say I don't have the balls. Well, I just did. So I'm probably not alone in being one of those people that said for the last 2 years, if it doesn't get fixed, I am not voting again. I'll just wait until quantum voting is actually publicly available. It's not running in the background, confirming things or what have you. I'm just going to wait till quantum voting is out there, because otherwise I'm participating in a charade in a game that I don't want to play in. And maybe you felt that way too. In fact, I was going to get on a video and stop just with that. And then my God works on me. And one of the things I thought about, if I'm going to accept that quantum voting was used in the last big election, that the misdirection of the results was known, and I do accept that. And then if I'm further going to accept that continuation of government was assured, even though it was done quietly, the only way that that continuation of government was able to happen was the fact that we did get out there and vote. Even if on one layer and level, our votes were misdirected, lost. By the way, anybody that tampered with votes, I think, should face life in prison at the least. Okay. Like I said, I'm not your typical grandma. As you'll find as time goes on. Okay. So the only way, if there was at least, and I'm going on faith here that there was, and we'll faith in the tarot cards, we'll find out here in a minute. If our votes were at least used for continuation of government, then they did matter. Even if we've had to live with the frustration that a public and surface correction wasn't made. And so I want to talk with the cards tonight and ask a question. I'm going to ask if quantum voting is in the United, I want to be real specific, because like I said, I know that tampering with and election integrity is a world issue. It's not just one country. So I'm going to ask the universe, in the United States, can Americans count on quantum voting, even if it's just running in the background, to help affect corrections and continuation of government? Okay, that's our question. I'm going to layer it also with a thought of if there's more about quantum voting that the universe would like us to know, especially from present day moving forward in the next couple of years, that would be fabulous too. I'm going to switch the pin. We'll see what the cards have to say. Here's what the cards had to say. I've never had a spread that didn't say so clearly, settle down, woman, settle down. I'll share that with you. I guess my passion about the subject shows up with the tower card. When you have a tower moment, it's transformative. And certainly when election integrity wasn't guaranteed and hasn't been and still isn't, it has caused some transformations, including but not limited to skyrocketing inflation and suspected or planned food shortages and gas prices going up and all the other crud we're living with. Okay, so here's where I got the universe. This is where we're getting into the situation. We were asking about quantum voting. The King of Wands is fair and truthful. And also the Page of Swords in the recent past is kind of there's a curiosity element to them, and we are curious. There is a truth and honesty thing here. So I am getting the definite impression that the universe said, settle down, woman, at least in the background. It ran. And then here's a celebration card as we move into present day. Now, I am not getting a strong sense that we're going to have it become mainstream, obvious, but it is running in the background and it is a cause for celebration because it was used for continuity government, at least for that. Even if there wasn't public restoration and corrections that millions of us were waiting for. Okay, moving ahead to the near future, this card signifies quite often some generosity. Card indicates that besides being generous, that there's quite often a gain of some sort and usually unexpected. So it's telling us that when it does come public, it's going to be without a lot of fanfare, just boom, here it is, guys. Worldwide, we're going to be doing quantum voting. Here's what it is, here's what it does, and here's what it'll do for you. So our advice and clarification cards. We've got two major arcanas here. And for this entire spread of only seven cards, we have three. So it's an important question. And I try to shoot for important questions. And this was really on my heart. The Hanged Man talks about looking at something in a different perspective. And definitely, if quantum voting comes into play for our world, not just my country, it is going to mean some changes. People are going to have to be happy with and live with the fact that it's one person, one vote. that the accountability is absolute, that there's no possible way to corrupt results or change them. And that is also bolstered by the world card. Now, while it's not our biggest clarification card, it's important. And these say that what's happening here is happening. So quantum voting is in play. Even though it's quietly and in the background, it's been used for our benefit. And it will become more obvious as in the near future, especially as we discuss it and treat it as commonplace. And I can probably stop being mad at our military for worrying so much about optics. Because it's the way of the future for our world, not just for my country, but for our world. And always remember, wreaths on tarot cards signify victory. So we are going to have that victory. We are going to be able to say bye-bye to people who are in positions of authority that weren't really given to them by those they represent. That day is coming. Now, how can we make it happen? Not by doing anything rash, not by doing anything that people could pounce on, but simply by saying, I don't consent to live in a world where unfair elections are to be expected. I may live in that world, but I don't consent to it. And I want to live in a world where quantum voting, as with so many other things that humanity needs, is openly available to all. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please like, share, you're welcome to comment, and subscribe. Remember, humanity has power and strength that evil fears. Own your strength, reject fear, and let's do this. Let's get humanity back on the destiny path that it was intended. And if I offended any military people with my words about not having the balls, I kind of sort of apologize, but really, seriously, it should have been fixed. Good night.